My name is Fred Davidorf, and my specialty is retina vitreous and ocular oncology. I was born in Lima, Ohio, and my family moved to Columbus when I was 5 years old. And we lived in Bexley, and I graduated from Bexley High School and went to Ohio State University for undergraduate school and for medical school, and did my internship at Los Angeles County General Hospital in Los Angeles, California. Came back to Columbus to do my residency at Ohio State, and then did my retina fellowship at Massachusetts Eye and Ear Infirmary, which is the Harvard Teaching Hospital for Ophthalmology in Boston. Well, I started thinking about medicine when I was like a little kid, and we had some family members that were ill, and I remember the feeling that, gosh, I wish I could do something. So, and it was kind of a hopeless feeling or a helpless feeling when a loved one's ill and you can't do anything. So I said, I think I want to be able to fix people, and that's where it started. Well, ophthalmology was something that I sort of became interested in when I was doing some research as a undergrad, actually on a cataract in a mouse, believe it or not. And so I knew a fair amount about ophthalmology just because I had done research in medical school. I sort of knew more than the next guy about ophthalmology, and it was fun, and that kind of was my origin. Well, retina really was, that interest was piqued during my residency. So my mentor is Bill Havner, and he was a superstar and one of the very few retina people in the country at that time. So we had strong training in retina, and I just loved it. And it's such a, such a creative field, and you do a lot of good. And so that's how I got into retina. When I was doing my fellowship, Bill Havner said, why don't you come back to Columbus? And at that time, Bill Havner was one of the busiest retina people in the world, really, and he needed help. So when I came back here, I remember coming in the doors, and he said, hey, Fred, I'm going to take off. And here that he dumps this huge practice on me. So from the very minute I got back here, I had this huge practice, which is still huge, and it's been fun. So academic medicine is the best of all worlds. You get to practice medicine, you get to fix eyes, you get to teach medical students and residents and fellows, and there's nothing like having inquisitive minds around you. There's always someone over your shoulder saying, why did you do that? And you gotta have an answer. And so it just makes you a smarter doc. Well, I've been interested in ocular melanoma since I started my practice, and actually Dr. Havner didn't really like melanomas, so he said, Fred, I think you should be interested in melanomas. And in those days, we sort of did what our mentors told us to do. So I took over sort of handling melanomas, and we actually established the standard of care for melanomas in the country using radioactive plaques. And that's the standard of care, and it was first done in Ohio State. So the changing face of medicine is primarily geared toward, because of molecular genetics. So the human genome, which was finished in 2006. It took 15 years for experts throughout the country to define the human genome of 25,000 genes. Now you can do the human genome with the next gen technique, that's what it's called, in 2 months. The information that you know is just unbelievable. So the point is, if you know a disease goes from A to B to C because of genes, we can now identify it and attack those. That's called target therapy. So the medicine of the future is going to be target therapy, affecting and altering the genes that are causing the problem. Well, I deal in sight, the most precious sense, and people come in, they can't see, operate, and they can see. So what greater gift can you give to people? I always tell the patient that I work for you, you don't work for me. So, I'm here to serve you, and I believe that. And so they can expect me to give them my best, just like I would a family member.